80 disabled persons in the Busoga sub-region who lost hands have been fitted with artificial hands courtesy of St. Joseph Community Health Center in Iganga with support from the World Action Fund. The victims complained about government's negligence and discrimination. Take a look.
Disabled persons who lost their hands and legs from different districts of Busoga flocked St. Joseph Community Orthopedic Health Center for free atrio artificial hands and legs. They turned up after being sensitized by the hospital after getting support from the World Action Fund. Some of these victims lost their hands and legs during work. The fitting exercise was led by a German technician and Patrick Mugweri.
This one particularly is a cosmetic hand for one with fullness. When someone sees you in a distance, you are a full man, not an arm sling, just swaying in the air like this. That's the purpose of this other component here.
Joshua Mukama, a resident of Magamaga in Mayuge district, who also lost his hand while at work at Kachira Sugar Factory, commended the donors as he narrated various challenges he goes through.
While I was operating a machine in Kakila Sugar Works, so the circulation machine cut off my hand, and I was treated. Then after I had problem of holding or doing other works, so now as I got this chance of getting a hand, I'm able to ride the motorcycle.
While Robert Kagwa from Bulanga, who missed the aid, expresses his frustrations.
I'm to know that things go phase by phase because the categories that they require to fit, I don't fall in it. So I'll be happy. I'm happy that I've known which category I'm falling in, and still hopeful that I'll be the next.
Fit some of the clients with the upper extremity, yeah, and then after a long run, they are going to use those hands for their own rehabilitation in the villages.
The chairperson of disabled persons in Luuka district, Ronald Woklia, said that over 1,000 people of similar nature need help.
I requested the government of Uganda so that they can support them, fund them, so that they can afford to buy these supportive devices.
Despite Parliament having representatives for the disabled persons to raise their concerns, many of them still face challenges. Story by Ivan Wachibi for the news in Iganga.